unpack the inverter box and check the accessories. Unpack the battery box and check the accessories. Choose a right installation place according to the installation space requirements. Make sure the ground is level. Place the battery box foot pads. Choose the installation position of the back plane. Drill holes in the collaboration position. Held in the expansion tube so that it is flush with the installation surface. Use screw to tighten up the back plate. Stack the second battery box on top of the first one. Choose the right installation position of the second back plane. Drill holes in the collaboration position. Put in the expansion tube so that it is flush with the installation surface. Use screws to tighten up the back plate. Tighten the left and right sides of the upper and lower battery boxes with the first back plate, and use two upper and lower connecting plates to tighten and fix the left and right sides of the upper and lower battery boxes, respectively. Place the inverter unit on the top of the second battery box. Tighten the left and right back panel screws, and use the upper and lower connecting plates to tighten and fix the inverter and the battery box. Use your mobile phone to scan the QR code and the Wi-Fi stake, and then screw the Wi-Fi stake into a fixed one. Connect a Buckham, H2, battery negative BAT-, and battery positive BAT+, according to the communication line identification. Connect the RS485 communication line of the meter and pay attention to the brown and white and brown connections. According to the T568B method, crimp the meter communication network cable and connect the meter communication. Connect the EPS port and a backup load. Connect the AC port and the power grid. Connect the ground wire. Connect the PV panel. Connect to CT. Pay attention to CT direction. Start operation. Turn on the PV switch, and battery circuit breaker.
ECACTUS Hub is the new commission application for installers from ECACTUS. It is available on iOS App Store and Google Play Store. First, log on the ECACTUS Hub app If you don't have an account, please do the registration using your email address. Select the correct data center. Then enter your account and password. Add a new site. The commissioning process consists of 4 steps. Only after transferring the site on owner's ECACTUS app account, the commissioning can be considered as completed. Step 1. Create a new site. Tap the plus icon to create a new site. Fill in all the information needed to complete the site details. When choosing the country or region, please make sure to choose the same country as the site owner. Otherwise, site transformation in step 4 will be failed. Also, owner's email address or cell phone is required. This information will be only used for after-sales service. Step 2. Add the device. Review this guidance and notes about the commissioning, as they can help you to finish the job more smoothly. Allow the access to the local network to add the device. The app needs local network and Bluetooth authorization, which is required for the commissioning process. Also note that only 2.4 GHz Wi-Fi is supported. The device does not support 5 GHz Wi-Fi at the moment. Input the target Wi-Fi account and password. Before tapping the confirm button, please check that the blue light in the Wi-Fi module blinks quickly. If there's no light blinks, remember to plug the Wi-Fi module and plug in after 10 seconds. Then tap the confirm button. The app will finish connecting the device process automatically. The app will need around 60 seconds to complete connection. Please wait patiently. Now you have successfully connected the device. Click OK to finish step 2. Step 3. Check preset configurations. Click on the Start Configuration button. Device will go through the checklist automatically. It will not take long if any of the configurations did not load successfully. Tap the refresh icon to reload. Make sure that the configuration meets the safety and requirements before saving it. Step 4. Transfer site. Double-check the site information field and make sure that all the information are correct. Also, make sure that the host site is ready to be transferred to the owner. After this QR code is generated, you need owner's mobile phone and the ECACTUS app. Ask owner to download the ECACTUS app on his or her mobile phone and finish the registration. Make sure that correct country and region is selected. Log in the ECACTUS app using owner's account and password. Tap on the Add Now button to find the QR code scanning function. Scan the QR code from the ECACTUS Hub app and click Confirm to accept the site. Now the owner can see the real-time status of their inverter and battery system remotely. Once the site is transferred to the owner, the process as ECACTUS Hub will be finished automatically. And in home page, the site will be listed for 72 hours for installers to do the after-sales service. Congratulations on the successful installation of new ECACTUS site. In the installer's ECACTUS Hub account, the site will be listed for 72 hours. After 72 hours, the site will be removed from ECACTUS Hub and only accessible from owner's ECACTUS app. To regain operational permissions for the device, cooperation from the owner is required. Firstly, need the owner to obtain a device sharing QR code in the ECACTUS app and then send it to the installer through the method such as screenshots. Secondly, the installer log the ECACTUS Hub app and scan the QR code shared by the owner. The device will be synchronized to the installer's ECACTUS Hub app automatically after installer scan the QR code. The validity period is also 72 hours. Installer and owner are able to see the device in their ECACTUS Hub app or ECACTUS app at the same time.